I want it all. I want it all. I want it all. And I want it now. Delayed gratification in the world of on-demand. Understanding our urge to give in to temptation. This article was originally published October 2nd, 2020. I mentioned this article in my most recent post, Sacrifice, Bargaining with the Future. And if you haven't read or listened to it, I recommend you doing so. I felt delayed gratification was a topic worth returning to, especially given the amount of things claiming to satisfy our desires. So without further ado, let's begin. Just one more episode. I'll only have a handful. One more drink and then I'll call it a night. Just one more game. I can pay for it later. And yes, you do. The forever conflict of satiating our impulsive desires has led us down many a dark path in retrospect. The ability to delay gratification, that is, to forgo the immediate satisfaction of something in order to achieve a more desired outcome at some future point, is usually the sign of mature psychological development. Thanks to technological advancements and the ever-present and far-reaching advertising industry, this has become an increasingly difficult thing to do. Psychologists continue to try and understand the concept of delayed gratification, and I'll talk more about the hot-cool theory in a moment. Most people are familiar with the marshmallow test in psychology to illustrate the concept of delayed gratification. Basically, you can have either one marshmallow now, or if you can delay your impulse for a period of time, e.g. 15 minutes, you will receive two. It is a fairly crude way to demonstrate the benefits of postponed fulfillment and examine what makes people more susceptible to temptation. The hot-cool theory of delayed gratification, as mentioned earlier, was proposed by Janet Metcalf and Walter Mischel some 20 years ago, as outlined in the image above. And I highly recommend you having a read-through of it. You can do so by clicking on the link to the original article in the description box. The hot-cool theory sought to describe two control systems underlying our behaviour. Hot, being the emotional system designed for quick responses to stimuli, and cool, being the rational and reflective thought system that can help us plan to achieve goals. Modern society has become very now, in the sense that I want it now with minimum ease and little to no inconvenience. And there is always something or someone waiting to fulfill that demand. This on-demand culture has made it difficult to wait on our indulgences. Why watch a TV show over a series of weeks when you can binge it in a weekend? Why wait until you can afford a new lounge when you can utilize store credit and 24 months interest free? Easy and on demand, modern society has something to gratify our every impulse. As I mentioned earlier, technological advances are enabling and encouraging our impulsivity by providing us with endless content to stimulate us, which in the end leaves us feeling rather drained. We've become overstimulated and thus have created a stimulus deficit, meaning we'll need to continue with more to satisfy us, akin to an addiction-like conditioning. This is why a significant number of people nowadays find it difficult to sit with stillness and slow down, and why meditation can help. There is a dangerous snowball effect with all this, as making things so effortlessly and readily available actually erodes the joy that we are seeking from these things, and creates a far worse effect when it is taken away. We must learn to sit with the discomfort and tolerate the frustration, anxiety, anger, and/or disappointment that may arise from failing to quench our instinctual pleasures in order to achieve our goals and long-term happiness. Delayed gratification is a healthy and rational alternative to giving in to immediate demands. For the creative people in the audience, we know this all too well, as our work rarely pays off immediately, and writing a novel is not a 5-minute job. Conditions which help or hinder delayed gratification include whether the focus is long-term or short-term, and the level of certainty and stress. These can be at the individual or societal level. Now, COVID-19 has created a lot of uncertainty and stress, and has shortened the outlook for many, so our ability to delay gratification has been hindered quite considerably. And I also wrote a piece last year about Staying Motivated in Uncertain Times, and I highly recommend you check that out also. People are more likely to delay gratification if their outlook or goals are long-term and in a predictable environment, because stability breeds confidence that things will remain roughly the same and that one can plan accordingly and achieve objectives that especially take a while to complete. A high stress tolerance is desirable to overcome our temptations, as we are more susceptible to impulsivity when stressed. Chocolate, anyone? The mental and physical distance we put between us and whatever is trying to grab our immediate attention is also crucial, as when a stimulus is hidden or further away, it is much easier to resist. Anyone who leaves their mobile phone within arm's reach will notice this. And there have been studies which have shown that even having your phone in the same room as you distracts your attention levels away from your current task. If you've made it to the end, well done. You've managed to forgo any immediate desires to garner some knowledge about how to overcome your immediate desires. Double win.